सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाविव संपृक्तौ वागर्थ प्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वंदे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ.
I would like to add another prayer.
This prayer also. Dhatu Brahmaiva Samprokto Jiva Akhyatam Uchyate Prakritikrut Subhantadir Dhatu Brahmatmane Namaha.
What this prayer says is Dhatu, the verb root, is Brahma, Brahmi Vriddhav, the Brahman which is Paramatma. Eva, Dhatu is nothing but Brahma alone. Because Brahma is the Jagat Karanam, it is from which everything is. And Shabda Brahma also can be said, the Brahma is in the form of Shabda. Means is that Dhatu, the verb from which all the words are manifest, that itself, the core of the all these languages is Dhatu, and that is Brahma. It is like Jagat Karanam. And Shabda, Pada, what is called as Pada, we saw Padam. Padam and Padartha, the object, there is no difference between Pada and Padartha. What we say Nama and Namni. One who has a name is Namni. Name is Nama. So there is no difference between name and form, the object. Pada and Padartha, there is a Nitya Sambandha. There is no difference between the two. Pada itself is Padartha. Therefore, Dhatu is the core of everything, and that Dhatu, Brahma eva samproktu. It is said by those who know very well, those who know the reality, the tattva, they say that Dhatu is Brahma, nothing else. What is Jiva then? Bhashyakara, Bhagavad Padacharya says, Shankaracharya says that Jiva Brahma eva, na aparaha. So Jiva is Brahma alone, but Jiva, when Jiva is a sanya, it's a name, Jiva gets Jivatvam, the status of being an individual, only when Brahma associates with a Sharira, some kind of a body. There are multiple bodies. When the Jiva name is used for Brahma, when he takes a, Brahma takes a form. Therefore, Jiva Akhyatam Uchyate. And the equivalent in the Vyakrana Prapancha is Akhyata. Akhyata is a verb. The declined verb. Dhatu is a verb root and akhyata is a something with an upadhi, something with an adjunct. So Dhatu, the Brahma with an upadhi of Sharira, with an upadhi of all these thing pratyas becomes akhyata as in a verb, declined verb, and that is Jiva. And Jiva samprokta, akhyatam uchyate. Dhatu Brahmeva Samprokta, Dhatu is called Brahma, indeed Dhatu is called as Brahma, is known as Brahma, while Jiva is known as the verb, declension of the Dhatu. Prakriti Krut Subhantadir, what is this entire Prapancha, Prakriti, the Maya, that Jagat is Krut and Subhanta. Subhanta we have seen nouns, Krut are basically what make a Pratipadika. You add a Pratyaya to a Krut Pratyaya to a Dhatu, so Dhatu takes a Thing Pratyaya, it becomes a verb. It becomes a declined kridantapada, the declined tingantapada. But if you add a kritpratya, it becomes a kridantapada. And kridantapada is a pratipadika, a noun base. So for example, Rama. Rama is a non-declined pada. Rama is a pratipadika. Then you add supratya, it can be declined as a noun. So that noun base, how do you create from a dhatu? You add a kritpratya to it, and therefore the Krut and Subhanta, the Pratipadika as well as the declined Pratipadika as a noun, both are called as Prakriti. And to that Dhatu Brahma, which is nothing other than Brahma, which I am actually in the form of, manifest in the form of the verbal root, and then thereby entire prapancha in the form of Shabda, Sabja Prapancha, and thereby Padartha also. To that Brahma, I do my Namaskara. And we do this prayer so that, I like this prayer. It is Vyakrana is a tool to understand the Tattva, because if you study Vyakrana and don't understand the Tattva, then Vyakrana is like, that's why Bhajagovindam Bhashyakara says, Bhagavad Padacharya says that Bhajagovindam there, Dukrunjkarane, nahi nahi rakshate Dukrunjkarane. Dukrunjkarane is the Kru Dhatu. With Dukrunj, it is in the Dhatu Patha, it is mentioned as Dukrunj, and it is a Kru Dhatu. That Kru Dhatu means the Vyakrana is not going to help you, is the general interpretation. There is more to it. But Vyakrana will not help you unless you know the Tattva. So Vyakrana should be used as a tool, as a stepping stone to understand the Tattva. So that's why we start with this prayer, which helps us both in study of Vyakrana as well as the Tattva. Okay, so with that prayer, we'll say it once again, since maybe others may not have been able to follow. Dhatu Brahmaiva Samprokto Jiva Akhyatamuchyate Prakritikrut Subhantadir Dhatu Brahmatmane Namaha. We have seen different lakaras and we have seen the declension gacchati. Eka tinga vakyam we have seen. One tinganta pada makes a vakya. And we were looking at the book where we were looking at the different karakas of the subanta pada. The subanta is made a noun declined, pratipatika is declined, the noun base is declined as a noun by adding supratyas, and these supratyas are 21 in numbers, suaujas, amauchas, ityadi, which we have seen. But it's not important to remember all the pratyas right now. If you just want to study the basics, if you want to get into Vyakrana deep, we didn't need to go. But what we need to understand is sup is a pratyaya, any of these 21 pratyas, and including sambodhana, which is prathama, prathama vibhakti, those are 21 pratyayas, and all put together are called as sup. And when they are added to a pratipadika, it makes a declined noun. And this noun declines in 7 cases, in 3 numbers each, singular, dual and plural. And each of these cases are called as vibhaktis. And these vibhaktis are either karakas or non-karakas. As karaka vibhaktis, there are 6 karaka vibhaktis, which is except the shashti. The 6th case is not a karaka vibhakti. It is a Sambandha Shashti. It is called Sambandha Shashti. The other 6 are Karakas because they have a Sambandha with the Dhatu, the Kriya. Karaka is it has a Sambandha with the Kriya, the verb. The Dhatu inside the verb has a connection with each of these Vibhaktis, therefore they are called as Karakas. Now these Vibhaktis also, these 6 can be Karakas, they can be non-karakas also. What are seen here are karaka meanings of those cases. There are non-karaka meanings also, and they are multiple. So we have to know whether it's a karaka vibhakti or a non-karaka when we are approaching a sentence analysis. First case is karta, and all this is in kartari prayoga. We have seen there is a kartari prayoga, which is a active voice, and Rama gacchati, Rama goes. And this is generally in present tense, what we see. Or other tenses are also possible, but karta in kartari. But in karmani prayoga, which is a passive voice, karta will not go in first case. There, karma will go in first case. So this is first case, prathama vibhakti, meaning karaka vibhakti. Karma in second case, this is in kartari prayoga also. And in karmani prayoga, if it is a dvikarmaka dhatu. Dvikarmaka dhatu means the dhatu can take multiple karmas, multiple objects. Then, depending on the type of dhatus, there are 16 categories, I remember 16 dhatus, I think, out of which there is a group of 10 and 6, which says that whether it is a primary karma or a secondary karma, and based on the dhatu, which should go in the first case in karmani prayoga, which should go in second case. So, it's a little technical, but there are some dhatus, it's good enough for us to know that there are some dhatus which can take more than one karma, meaning they can take two karmas. They are called dvikarmaka. Dvi means two. Dvikarmaka dhatus. So there, this karma, there can be in karmani prayoga, there can be a karma in second case, but it is not the karma which is being talked about. The karma which is in first case is denoted by the verb in Karmani Prayoga. In Kartari Prayoga, Karta is denoted in the, and the denoted goes in first case. So Rama Gachati, but we'll see the Karmani Prayoga a little later. I don't want to confuse. Then there is Karanam. Karanam, we had seen, Karanam is the instrument of the action which is used. So if you say that a person eats with his hand, then with his hand, that with his hand. Yeah, another thing I forgot to mention is, most of you may be knowing, but in Sanskrit, the sentence formation is such that the word which is declined has the connection with the dhatu or with another word, another noun in Shashti. The word declined word itself has the connecting words also. Like what you have and, of, all these connections which are there with all these words which actually connect in English, there are nouns and there are these, I don't know what they're called, they are these connecting words which connect the two words. Like I want to say Rama goes, there is no connecting word here, goes is the verb and Rama is the karta of the sentence, agent of action. But if I have to say Rama goes to vanam, goes to a forest, so forest is the noun but to is that connecting word which says that to forest, and to forest, both these words put together make up a vibhakti, make up a declined word in of karma in Sanskrit. This is the reason that you can reorganize the words any which way in Sanskrit and it still will mean the same. You can't say Rama goes to forest as to forest Rama goes, you may say poetically, but to and forest have to be in the same order. You can't separate out to and say forest to goes Rama. It will have no sense. But in Sanskrit you can say Gachati vanam Ramaha, Ramaha vanam gachati Ramaha, vanam Ramaha gachati, all sorts of combinations are possible and they will mean the same thing because the vibhakti artha includes this connection with another verb, with the verb or another noun. It is embedded into the declension itself. So that is the beauty of the language, and this allows a lot of poetic composition also by reorganizing the words in whichever chandas, whichever meter, without changing the meaning. And it also allows the possibility of multiple meanings by reordering the words. Multiple meanings are also possible, same meaning is also possible, and multiple meanings may be in the intention of the poet or the author as well. So coming back to Karana, Karana, the Karaka Vibhakti means instrument of action. So one eats with a hand. With a hand or with a spoon, one sees with a spectacle. So with spectacles, with a hand, with this connection is called the Karana because it is the instrument. It is a tool, which is a sadhana, which is called as a means to achieve the action. That is Karana. Sampradanam. Sampradanam, I mentioned last time that when something is given without the expectations of taking back, that is called a sampradanam. Technically, that is what sampradana is, but loosely people use it. When a book is loaned also, they use it. Apadanam. Apadanam is a source of action. That non-moving entity in a particular action of indicated by one single verb, which is still that entity which is still in that action and the other is separated from it. That still entity is called apadanam. That is the technical definition of apadanam, which is a source of action. Adhikaranam. Adhikaranam is where the action is happening, locus. So say bhutale ghata asti is a sentence. So bhutale, bhutale is seventh case singular, meaning bhutala means the base of the bottom of the floor, as in it's basically floor. Bhutala as in it's the tala, surface of the earth. So surface of the earth is the ground, which is the floor. So that bhutale in seventh case means it's a locus where the action of bhutale ghata asti. So that asti, the verb as dhatu with decline in first case singular is asti. So it is there. What is there? Ghata. Ghata is pullinga shabda. So it will decline ghataha. Ghataha with visarga. Ghata asti, the pot is there. Where is it there? It is on the ground. So the action of being asti, the action asti is happening on the ground. So that is the locus of the action, that is adhikarana. This is where we were. I just thought I'd do a little review because I had to close it fast to end last time. So that's the Karaka Vibhakti. Now other so sentences like okay, these are in English. Okay, we'll have a look at these English sentences. I'll mention the Sanskrit as we go. So karta is the primary factor related to the action. Anyway, I think we'll come back to this. I prefer to do it with Sanskrit. Let's do the cases. Yeah, I would like to open. Let's see. I'll open the book next time. I have to look for the book. But here, let's say, let's write it as we go. So we. So let's say bhu dhatu. Bhu dhatu. In the dhatu patha, you'll find this bhu as dhatu listed as bhu. And bhu, the meaning of that is given in seventh case. So bhu sattayam. We'll see this seventh case a little later. But when I say bhu sattayam or bruhi vriddhau, the bruhi, the first word is the dhatu, the second word is its meaning. So this is the sattaya means the pratiparika is satta. In the meaning of satta. Satta means in the meaning of existence. So bhu, the dhatu bhu is in the meaning of existence. When I decline this in lat lakara, I have to add lat lakara here. Lat lakara means these lat lakara, this lat is a pratyaya. Lat pratyaya is added in vartamana kala. Vartamana kale lat. So vartamane lat. Vartamana kale lat. In vartamana kala, I add a, in the sense of, in the meaning of vartamana kala, I add a lat pratyaya to the dhatu bhu. When this is declined, I'll get these forms. I'll get bhavati, bhavataha, bhavanti, bhavasi, bhavataha, bhavatha. Then bhavami, bhavava, bhavamaha. Okay, these are the forms. This is singular. These three, the bhavati, bhavasi, bhavami are singular. These rather, it's difficult to mark. Bhavati, bhavataha, bhavanti, these three are the prathama vibhakti. In tinganta also, this tinganta, verb. Tinganta also, you call it as vibhakti. But it is not commonly used. There we'll say purusha, we'll say prathama purusha. So this is prathama purusha, third person. This is madhyama purusha, second person. And uttama purusha, first person, I. So when it is dealing with neither you or me, I'll say he, she or it. He, she, it goes, meaning one goes, two people are going, and more than two people are going. So plural, they go. He, she, it goes, they too go, and they all go. This is the meaning of the first three. Bhavasi is the second person, Madhyama Purusha. Say you go, or you are going, or will you go. In this construct, you use Bhavasi. Tom Bhavasi. So Tom is you. Tom Bhavasi, you are, the, not go, I'm sorry, I'm using go, but that's for Gach, because Gach is still, Gach is sitting in my mind. I should have used Gach actually. Okay, let me Bhavati. Bhavati is you are. As in bhavati is he, she or it is, bhavata is they two are, and bhavanti are more than two people are, they are. Similarly here, instead of bhavasi, if you say gachati, bhavati you say gachati, then he, she, it goes. So third person meaning as in he, she, it is, or he, she, it goes in gachati. Similarly bhavata will become gachataha, bhavanti will become gachanti. Bhavasi will become gachasi, bhavataha will become gachataha, and bhavata will become gachata. Bhavami, gachami, bhavavaha, gachavaha, and bhavamaha, we all are, that will be gachamaha. So what this means is, he, she, it is, or he, she, it goes, based on which dhatu you are using, that dhatu meaning will apply, and you will use in the third person as he, she, it, they both or they all. And here you alone, you both or you all. And here I alone, both of us or All of us. This is how the usage is. So all of us are will be bhavamaha. All of us will go or are going or all of us go will be gacchamaha. This is the declension of lat lakara. Now I'll just mention with a simple how to identify a dhatu. In the lat lakara, you separate out this ti, because if you know tiptas ji, tiptas, if you know the sakara becomes visarga and this jha is replaced by anti, then you just replace the last, separate out bhavati, bhavasi, this bhavami, bhavavaha, bhavataha, bhavatha, bhavanti, anti, and tha. Actually, this anga, here this is anti. Now, if you separate this out and you can make out this anga, which is called the anga. Anga is that entity to which a pratyaya is added. So this entity to which this is the entity to which this pratyaya is added. This bhava, you can identify the dhatu if you know the gana. So if you can find out the gana, or you know what is the modification. If you know sandhi karya, then you will know what change has happened here. So bhu has become bhava because this bhu is actually here. This bhava, bhava is bhu dhatu. Plus a, which is a vikarna pratyaya in first gana. We'll see this vikarna pratyaya. I had said that this when tip is added, it attracts a vikarna pratyaya based on the gana. This is the first gana. First gana, parasmi pada dhatu, to which a vikarna pratyaya is added. And this sandhi between bhu and a will be bhava. So if you know the sandhi and you know this, then you can separate out and say that bhu is the dhatu. And then bhu is the dhatu, once you know, you can look up the dhatu pata and see the meaning bhu sattayam. This is how you can make out the meaning that bhavati, we know that it means he, she, it. But what the meaning is, he, she, it, what is the he, she, it, what is the meaning, one is doing what? That dhatvartha and thereby the tingartha will know only when the dhatu is known. And once we decipher the dhatu by reverse engineering this anga, we'll say that this bhu sattaya, meaning that in the meaning of existence, therefore we say he exists, she exists, it exists, or he, she is, it is, one is. That is how we will translate. Similarly, gach dhatu, the gam dhatu becomes gach. So, gach is common, gam to gach. We don't need to know the adeshas. This is a little deeper vyakrana as to how the form changes, etc. But if we separate out a gachati, you separate out ti, and you separate out akara as the vikarana pratyaya, then we know gach is the dhatu, and gach we know comes from gam. In some cases it will be difficult, but gacha also, if you know, some of these vyakrana books will list gacha also, and we know it means to go. So to go, therefore we have the meaning he, she, it goes, or if you see gachami, we know that I go. So this is the basic karya to know the tingantha pada in lat lakara, and this applies to all lakaras. But what happens is that these pratyas undergo some kind of a change based on the lakara. For example, this ti will become te in Atmanepada. Let's look at one Atmanepada form. Lab dhatu would be good to have a look at, I think. So I'll just show you that in Dhatupata how is this seen. In Dhatupata you will see this as Dulabash Praptau. This is the Dhatvartha in 7th case. Prapti is the Pratipadikam. Declined in 7th case it will be Praptau. So Dulabash in this, the content will be Lab. This Anuswara, whatever you see here, this will all this, this last letter, This is all packaging letters. I mentioned they are called it letters. And do also will go. What will remain is lab. So lab will be the, in some dhatu patas you will see in which don't deal with vyakrana proper, vyakrana as a sutra based, they will just list the dhatu as lab. So this is a lab dhatu. And lab dhatu will, in Atmanepada, you see this tip has become, ti has become te. So e has replaced with te. That's the only difference. If you can make out this takara and separate it out, whatever is along with, if you separate out, then you will get the anga. this will be lab, labha. And if we see, this is bhavadi gana. Bhavadi gana is the first gana. We'll see the names also, gana names little later. I want to complete the atmani and parasmai declensions of lat lakara so that we can identify some forms and form some sentences. And when we go or look at the sentences, when we see in tattvabodha. Lab. So lab is the dhatu. If you can separate this akara the way you separated in with bhava and with a sandhi, here there is no sandhi. It is just varnamelana. Varnamelana is the varna consonants or letters. Letters including consonants and vowels, they have come together. There is never a sandhi between halanta, hal, as in a consonant and a vowel. There is not never a sandhi. There is only varnamelana. They just come together and they are written together or pronounced together. But there is a sandhi. Sandhi is only there in between. Sandhi changes are there only between a vowel and another vowel, between vowels. So labha, if you can separate out akara, you'll get lab. And lab, once you know, then in the dhatu pata you'll see lab. If you search for lab, you'll get lab prapto. Prapto means prapti is attainment. And if we don't know the meaning of prapti, this also can be looked up in the dictionary. So if you look up prapti, if we know the declension of noun, so what becomes prapto if we know, then we can decipher this also. We'll see that in Subanta Prakriya. When we look at the nouns, how are the declensions, we'll know that this is seventh case singular. And seventh case singular of what? It will, in Dhatu Pata, it will always be seventh case singular. Or seventh case dual also can be there if there are two meanings. If there are more than two meanings, then it will be plural. So it will be praptau, but praptau and another word, then it will be dual. And if there are three words or more words, it will be in plural. So this prapti meaning, the declension is prapti. From prapti it has become prapto. So pratipadikam is prapti. If prapti is the noun base, then if we look up prapti, what is the meaning in the dictionary, we'll find that prapti means. I'll show you how to look up the dictionary also. If you prefer computers, then you can look up this prapti word in a golden dictionary. So prapti, you see, prapti, the meaning is occurrence, or you see reach, extent, attainment, all these meanings will be there. Attaining, obtaining. So all these meanings apply. So what this will mean finally is labhate. The form is different, but it is in the same meaning of vartamana kala lat, which says that labhate attains or obtains. One attains, he, she, it attains. They both attain will be labhete. And more than two people attain, they all attain will be labhante. Labhase, you attain. Labhete, you both attain or you both obtain something, get something. Labhadve, all of you attain. Labhe, I attain. Labhavahe, we both attain. Labhavahe, we all attain. Now, if we look at this ta is common. Ti and te, the only a, ikara has become ekara. This taha, aha has become here. So here, if you, last time I think Bhavya had asked for the common pratyas. After removing the it letters and some modification, you will see ite or ete here, or ate. Those are the forms you will see. But here, same Tiptas ji has modified forms. And these forms, modified forms, can also be seen as to what can be added to a dhatu directly to form a declined tingantapada. So labhate, labhete, labhante. But if you read a few times, you will get it. You will not need to know the pratyas. You will know labhate, labhete, labhante. Labhase, labhete, labhadve. Labhe, labhavahe, labhavahe. How will you get this tip? This T, actually not this T, this is parasmi pada pratyaya, but I am saying ting pratyaya. So tiktas ji, I should have written the pratyaya next to this. So this is tik. So tiktas ji, this is tiktas ji. Tiktas, so you know what change has happened. So tas, the sakara has become visarga. And bhavanti, here in bhavanti, tiktas ji, ji has become anti. So jha takes antadesha. Bhavasi is sip. This pakara goes and you get only C as the C remains. This is thus, just like this thus, but mahaprana. What is called as mahaprana? Mahaprana means a more breathing has to be done, the more aspiration has to be used. So bhavati, bhavataha, bhavanti, this bhava, and then bhavasi, bhavataha, bhavathas, bhavathas will become bhavataha. This is bhavatha without any visarga. This is tha. This pratyaya is tha itself. Then bhavami, bhavami is mip. This all three, in singular you see there is a pakara is an ith letter. This pakara goes. Based on that there will be some rule made. Then bhavami, bhavavaha is vas. And bhavamaha is mas. So you will see everywhere the sakara, ending sakara becomes visarga. The only thing is that here in these two, bhavavaha and bhavama, there is a anga dirgha. There is a dirgha which happens here. It is not bhavavaha, it is bhavavaha. And it is not bhavamaha, it is bhavavaha, bhavamaha. Similarly here bhavami, it is not bhavami, it is bhavami. So this last three, which is the uttama purusha, there you get dirgha in the anga before the mip, vas and mas pratyas. So this is the parasmaipada. In atmanepada, here it is. See, here you see this a means atmanepada. Forget anit right now. It is that which can take an it. It is an agama, which is a it is something which is added. It is an addition which is done. Forget this. Otherwise something would have come and sit. There is an ikara which will sit here. If it is a it is not anit, it is it. Anit means not it. So this is also marked in the dhatu pata, but let's not go there. Labate. So this is ta atam jes. So ta atam. The pratyas that we saw last time, there are 9 plus 9, 18 pratyas. So we have tiptas ji, siptas tha, mipvas mas, ta atam jha. This is jha. This jha will become anta. Jha will become anta. Then we have ta atam jha, thas, tas atam dham. So just a second. So thas. This thas, there is a sutra thasas se. So this thas becomes se. So this thas, I'll just mention this. We'll see the changes in the forms a little later. This thas, this just think that this thas becomes se. So se is the pratyaya. And thas atham. This is same as this takara here in bhavat. This thas had become thas here. Mahaprana. Here also this atam has become atham. Only mahaprana changes there. Nothing else is there. What happens is this arm, this last a, the last body starting with a vowel is replaced with a. That is how you get labhe te. This te and labhe a ate. The form will be ate here. That is how the change happens. And this is dvam. And dvam. Here you see this am. Am is the starting with the last vowel. Last vowel in this is a, akara. This is this akara. After dvakara, there is akara. And akara, makara put together is am. That last entity, last segment, which starts with a vowel, that is replaced with a. So this is actually, if you see what is this, this is dva plus a plus ma. This is how the so this is how if I separate out, this is how I write dvam. And anything starting with a vowel, the segment, ending segment will take a adesha. It will become a. So you will get dve. You put them together, you will get dve. So this will become dve. That is why you are getting labat dve. This is, so atmanepada in lat is a little tricky. In other lakaras, atmanepada pratyas remain like that. So we can see some lakaras, you can see by atam you can make out the form. This it will be ending with atam. So he has made a set of pratyas which will be simpler across all lakaras. So some lakaras may be difficult, but some lakaras will be simpler. With a shorter set, he has Pani Maharshi has made these pratyas. I'll remove this dve. So this will be dvam. Thas atam dvam. It vahi mahi. So this will be it. And it's, if you see it, what is the last vowel? E is the last vowel. It is the first as well as the last vowel. This it, entire it will be replaced by a. And you will get the lab plus it would have been, will become a. Labhe. Similarly here, This is it. Id vahi, vahi mahing, vahi. Be vahi and mahing. Vahi mahing. Here also vahi is ahi. Ahi is the so this e is not it. Otherwise it would I had mentioned it as anuswara. It is not anuswara. This va, a, ha and e. E is the last vowel. That e will take a adesha. It will become vahe. Similarly here mahing. This last letter will go being a consonant. This e will become this ing. This nya goes and then e will become a. Everywhere it has become a. This e in the act labat. This labate. The a has become a. Arm has become a. Ant in this ant. The anta a has become a. Similarly, all of these have the last segment starting with a vowel become a. So the forms you get are labate, labhete, labante, labase, labhete, labadve, labhe, labhavahe, labhamahe. That's the declension of the Atmanepada and Parasmepada in Lat Lakara. Now, in other Lakaras, some Lakaras can be seen directly. You can separate out the pratyas, the thing pratyas, and make out the body and reverse engineering the dhatu. In many cases, it will be straightforward as we practice. In some Lakaras, it is tricky unless we know what is the change that is happening with the pratyas. Other thing is that some Lakaras, if you know lat Lakara, then another Lakara, lrit Lakara, which is a general future tense, can be known very easily. You just in Bhavati, there is a isya added, isya here. So if you add isya between this body, anga, and the tip, the thing pratyaya, this isya will sometimes become ishya. So actually you can say ishya only. If you add ishya, then you will get the lrit lakara form everywhere. You just add ishya, and when you add ishya, this akara undergoes lopa, or it is elided. So this anga will, instead of bhava, it will become bhav, and then this e will replace that last a. You will get bhavishyati. So if I just add this ishya, I'll get bhavishyati. So this is the only difference. This is the only difference between a lat lakara and a lrit lakara. This is bhu plus lrit lakara. Lrit lakara, which is in the general future tense. And you can make out by, if you don't remember, see bhavishyat kala. That is why you said bhavishyat kala. Bhavishyati, bhavishyati is bhavishyat kala. That is the kridanta, but kridanta form, bhavishyat kala. Bhavat kala, bhavat kala will be the vartamana kala, is called bhavat kala. That bhavat, bhavishyat. This is how you know it is. This only change is this ishya. Ishya has come. And similarly, if you add bhavishyati, bhavishyataha, bhavishyanti, bhavishyasi, bhavishyataha, bhavishyata, bhavishyami, bhavishyavaha, bhavishyama. The only change, if you know in a sutra, it's a ishya has to be added to the anga. In all dhatus, you can know the, if you know the lat lakara, you can know the lrit lakara very easily. So I'm just mentioning what is the benefit of sutras. This thing is quite vast. There are 10 lakaras and atmanepada forms, kartari prayoga, karmani prayoga. All this become a little vast to remember. If you have a good memory, then go ahead and learn by rote. But if one does not have a good memory, these can be easily learned by sutras. We can identify. It will be difficult to make forms unless we know all sutras, but it is easier to identify, and we want to know how to identify when we read Tattvapoda or Bhashya. So this is the process. I wanted to do Rama Shabda, but anyway, let's see. It's already, yeah, only a few minutes left. Anyway, we'll just look at the Rama Shabda. At least we'll read it in Subanta. Okay. I'll just copy paste, so there's not much time, so. So find somewhere. This one Rama Shabda will read through and stop. Oh, that's not good. Okay. Let me just quickly write here. Okay, here's the declension. There's a declension in Napunsakalinga also. Okay, this is the Rama Shabda, Akaranta Pullinga Shabda. Say Ramaha, Ramau, Ramaha, Iti Prathama, Ramam, Ramau, Raman, Iti Dvitiya, Ramena, Ramabhyam, Ramaihi, Iti Tritiya, Ramaya, Ramabhyam, Ramebhyaha, Iti Chaturthi, Ramat, Ramabhyam, Ramebhya, Iti Panchami, Ramasya, Ramayoho, Ramanam, Iti Shashti, Rame, Ramayoho, Rameshu, Iti Saptami, and then He Rama or Bho Rama, Bho Ramo, He Rama, He Ramo, He Ramaha, Iti Sambodhanam. If we, now this is easy to remember than learn by sutras. If we can read this once a day, maybe sometimes, if we read across few days, we'll get it. Ramaha, Ramo, Ramaha, Prathama. Then you see He Rama. So the visarga has been dropped in Sambodhana when you address a person directly, but Ramo and Ramaha are same in Prathama and Dvitiya. So if you see what are the common forms here, Ramo, Ramo, these first two and this second case also is same. In Sambodhana, in Prathama Vibhakti and Dvitiya Vibhakti, Dvivachana, Ramo, Ramo is same. There is not much to learn. Once you know the first line, this first three, then you get the in second line you get the two forms as well, and in Sambodhan also you get two forms. Ramaha and Ramaha, Ramaha, this is same. And in this Sambodhan only Visarga you have to drop, so you get this form also, Rama. In the this one, this Tritiya Dvivachana, Chaturthi Dvivachana and Panchami Dvivachana will always be same for all kinds of words, whether it is Trilinga, whether it is Napunsakalinga, all will be same. Similarly, Chaturthi Bahuvachana and Panchami Bahuvachana will also be same. And Shashti Divachana and Saptami Divachana will also be same. And in most cases, Panchami, this Panchami and Shashti Ekvachana will also be same in Halanta, for example, or in Strilinga. Only in Rama Shabda it is difficult, Ramat and Ramasya. Forget this Ramataha here right now. This Ramat is the form and Ramasya is the form in Shashti. This will also in most cases be same. So you have to just learn a few, you get the others for free. This is the way you decline a Rama Shabda, Akaranta Pullinga Rama Shabda. We'll stop here. Sorry, I took 2 more minutes. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.